And does one character stop and the other take over? Are you conscious of the two sides of your character?
Very often I am, and then sometimes I'm not. And when I catch myself realizing that I have reverted back into being Ertha May, I have
to... Ertha May, which is what your name was when you were very poor,
yes.
And your mother actually passed you on to somebody else.
Yes, she gave me away to a family that eventually wound up using me as a work mule. And my mother gave me to this family because the man that she wanted to marry said, I don't want that yellow gal in my house. It meant being an illegitimate child and also the wrong color. You are not wanted by the blacks, and the whites couldn't care less. So this black family, who had two teenage children, used me as a, whatever they could use me as a working person. And then I was also by the young gentleman in that family.
Are you? How old were you then?
I know people don't believe it when I say I don't know how old I am, but I know somewhere I'm way past 60.
But how old were you then?
Not way past 60, but I'm way past 50. But I was really still about 5-6 years old.
And all that abuse going on.
Yes, and all of that abuse was going on, and I couldn't tell anybody about it because who would have believed me? And the young boy, he was not the nicest kid in the world, and neither was his sister, who also, I didn't know anything about lesbians in those days. And she took tried. And there were times when the whole family was gone into the fields or something like that, harvesting, picking cotton or whatever they were doing, and we were left in the house alone. The two teenagers would tie me in what we call a croak sack, I think you call it, what potatoes come in.
Yeah.
They would tie the sack around my waist and then tie me to a tree, and with a peach tree switch they would beat my bottom until I was bleeding, and I only had one thing to wear, and that was also made of potato sacking. And
Well, I can understand how, I've been several years of that, but it's going to mark you for life.
Well, you try not to have it. Leave a scar on you, emotionally or mentally, but of course. And even though the physical scars are gone, and you start talking about it like we are talking about it now, and you try to not get emotional about it, but all of a sudden those feelings do come back. And the idea of them tying me to a tree, and you're not able to escape at all.
Yes, and then you had an auntie, your mother's sister, who looked after you then in New York. Isn't that right? You went to New York to your mother's sister, Auntie Mamie?
Yes, Auntie Mamie.
Did she look after you any better?
No. My aunt was very, very strict. My aunt was a very tall lady. She was about 6 feet tall and also very fair in complexion. She's half Cherokee, very majestic looking. I was deathly afraid of her, even from the sight when I first saw her. I was terribly afraid of her. But she had no children of her own. She was never married. And I think that she brought me up north to New York out of Christian duty, you know, because she got a letter from the South that told her that if I was not taken away from this family, that they would either starve me to death or beat me to death or work me to death. And therefore, she decided that she would take me on into New York. But she wasn't any better. She was also abusing me.
You ran away from her, too?
Yes, but I think God certainly has his funny ways, you know, because I was trying to get away from her, but where do you go? What do you do? I used to stay away from her as much as I could, and I kept running away. And whenever I had a few pennies, I could, Subway was a nickel, for instance. And I used to get on the subway and ride from one end of Manhattan to the other, hoping that the conductor wouldn't see me, because they used to have conductors on the subways at the time, and then get off on the other end and get back on and he couldn't see me.
You seem to be...
And just keep riding all night long until daybreak.
Running away from your life.
Well, I don't think I was running away from life. I was running away from rejection. I was running away from not being accepted.
Has that stayed with you? I mean, do you find that, is that why you think perhaps you're an extrovert, that you're looking for attention, you're looking for affection?
But Mr. Vaughan, you know something? I'm not an extrovert. I can tease as Ertha Kitt, but as Ertha may forget it. I'm hiding under the, behind the bushes, behind the chairs, behind everything you possibly could, I could possibly find to hide behind. Because I never have been with that kind of security within Ertha May that makes me feel that she will ever be accepted. I don't think Ertha, in myself, in my subconscious. And when I'm writing the book, when I was writing the book, I realized that more and more. And that's why maybe sometimes I am going around looking like the urchin that I really know I am inside of myself. And not wearing any makeup and not caring about what I look like. That little ugly duckling was always told she's an ugly duckling. Nobody wants you. And she's trying so hard to find somebody that says, Ertha May, it's all right. You want it too. But nobody's done that yet. Maybe I have not given them a chance to do so, I don't know. But she keeps hoping.
But you must, people must have shown you affection and love in your life. Is it that you can't accept it?
The public and my daughter, yes. The public.
Never.
If
never,
it wasn't for the public, a man has always wanted to lay me down, but he never wanted to pick me up. And the men that did have real love and affection for me were the ones that never touched me. That was Orson Welles, Ruby Rosa. And there were a couple of real love, strong love that men have had for me. Two of them, John Barry Ryan III and Arthur Lowe Jr. But then the mothers step in. And I think very often the mothers, particularly with boys who come from extremely wealthy families and they are the only son, they would rather them marry trash and marry someone of color, no matter how wonderful a person that person of color may be.